One minute. I think it started recording. Okay.
Okay, children.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, all of you. We can start with today with the ASA congruence condition. Last class we were discussing about SSS congruence condition and SAS congruence condition. Brilliant. Now, can you tell me what is SSS? Yes, Gobiga Shankar. SSS congruence condition.
When all the sides are equal, the length of all the sides are equal to the other triangle also.
Not like that. You have to tell me more clear. It should be clear. Okay. What is that actually? It is a congruence condition criteria. It is a congruence criteria. So what you have to say is all the three sides of one triangle.
Side.
No. SSS. All the three sides of one triangle is congruent to corresponding three sides of other triangle.
Three sides of one triangle are corresponding to other three sides of other
then
triangle.
The triangles are congruent to each other. Okay, what is it? When the sides of all the three sides of one triangle is congruent to the corresponding three sides of the other triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. Clear? So that is the way you have to answer it. Okay. Now SAS, can you tell me, Baja? Baja, can you tell me SAS? Yes, AS. From that itself, you know what it is, isn't it? SAS.
Side angle side.
Side angle side. That angle have some peculiarity. What is the peculiarity, you know? Angle should be included angle, isn't it? Included angle. Two sides and the included angle of one triangle is equal to two sides and the included angle of the other triangle.
Included angle means?
See, I didn't take this for you. SAS, I have taken, no? Yesterday?
Yes, ma'am.
Included angle means two sides are there and then the side, one angle will be included in that. That is called SAS. We have done problems based on that. One or two problems we have all, it is already over. Two sides will be given and then angle in between. ABC, one triangle ABC. AB is one side, BC is another side. Angle B will be the included angle. Okay. So we can...
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we have done problems also. Then why are you asking like that?
On that day, I had a network problem. So that I couldn't.
Okay. That is the reason. So let me check whether any figure is there in this. Then I'll show you. Now we are going to study ASA congruence condition. Okay. This period we'll be studying ASA congruence condition. SAS is not in this. We have done a lot of problems based on that, children.
SAS. Okay. We asked the record.
See this? I think this one was the problems related to SAS. ASA. This is ASA. ASA. Okay, this is ASA. No, all this is ASA.
No issues. I will check it in the what?
No, I have explained it. Okay, two angles and the side in the. ASA we have. SAS, two sides and one middle angle. Okay, what about others? Did you understand? Children, SAS congruence condition?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so today we'll see ASA. What is ASA? Then you will get it. Okay, ASA. ASA criterion means angle, side, angle, congruence, criterion. Okay. Just simply read it in your mind. You won't understand, but simply read it in your mind. I'll explain to you. Yes, children. Did you read? If under a correspondence, two angles and the included side of a triangle are equal to corresponding angles and included side of the other triangle, then the triangles are congruent. Okay, I'll show you another figure. Then it will be clear to you. Look at this one. Just have a look at this. Okay, see the first triangle. First triangle, you see. First triangle, first two, first question. Two triangles are given. Angle A is equal to angle F in the second triangle. So that 40 degree. Or you check first triangle. Okay, look at the first triangle. Two angles are given, angle A and angle B. One is 40 degree, the other is 60 degree. Which is the included side in between that two angles?
B. No. C.
No, which is the side? Side means what? Line segment. Isn't it? Side is line segment. Which is the line segment included between angle A and angle B?
Angle A and B.
Which is the side included?
3.5 centimeter one.
That is AB. Side AB. Okay. Side AB. How many sides are there for that triangle? Can you tell me?
Three sides.
Isn't it? Which are the sides? Wait, I'll take it. 1 minute. Look. Which are the sides? What are the sides given here in that first triangle?
AC. AB
is one side, BC is another side, then AC is the third side. Okay. AB, BC, and AC. In that, angle A, you saw 40 degree. Angle B, you saw 60 degree. Which is the side lying in between these two angles? Is the side lying between these two angles?
Angle AB.
AB, where you are saying angle? There, I asked you the side. Side line means segment. It is line segment.
AB.
Line segment AB, isn't it? Look, which is 3.5 centimeter. Line segment AB is the side lying between 40 degree and 60 degree angle, isn't it, children?
Yes, ma'am.
So side and angle, why are you saying like that? You should say immediately, no? See the figure once more. It's a question. Look, so check with the second one. Okay.
And we only need, no, ma'am, we only need to find out the AB, that's all.
No.
First only included angle.
First, you should know what is meant by included side. I explained what is included side of a triangle. Okay. Why it is called included side? Because it is lying in between two angles. Okay.
Ma'am, if we say AC and CB, then it's AB. If we say AB and BC, then it's AC, right?
A included side will come only between angles. Angle A, between angle A and angle C, included side is AC. Okay. Okay. Included side will be AC. Between angle C and angle B, which is the included side, BC is the included side.
Okay.
Now check angle A of first triangle. Angle A of first triangle is equal to angle E of the second triangle. Isn't it? Sorry. Angle A is equal to
angle E, right?
Angle F.
Angle A is equal to angle F.
F. Angle B is equal to angle E. Angle E. And which is the included side in the first triangle? AB is the included side. That is equal to EF, which is the included side of the second triangle. Both are 3.5 centimeters, isn't it? Did you understand? Others, all of you can respond, no? Only I can hear Suraja will speak, Baja may speak sometimes, and sometimes Amrita Parvati will be answering, or
Gobiga Shankar
Will be answering. I cannot hear anybody else sound there. Why? I want all of you to answer. Okay. I want all of you to answer. I don't know whether it is screen share or not. Now I will come back. Did you understand what is this included side, children?
Huh? Yes, ma'am.
Included side means between two angles, one side is there. That's all. That is called included side. Okay. Now again, write down these two questions. Write down these two questions which I am showing, the same questions which I have shown you. Then we have to find out the congruency between them.
Ma'am, we are asking like if A and B and C and B is given, then the included angle will be A and C, right?
I'll tell you. Take three sides of the triangle. Okay, three sides. I'll show you. That is better. I'll draw on the board and show you. Otherwise, if that is not clear, there is no use of speaking anything else. Look. Can you see the board? No. I'll stop sharing. Okay, now you can see the board, no? You can see the board?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, I am going to draw a triangle. See, this is a triangle. This is angle A, this is angle B, and this is angle C. Now, angle A here, angle B here. Which is the included side between angle A and angle B? It is AB. Okay. Side AB is the included side between angle A and angle B. Then, which is the included side between angle B and angle C? It is BC. Side coming between these two angles. Which is the included side? BC is the included side between these two angles. Clear? Now, suppose angle A and angle C is given. Which is the included side between these two angles?
AC.
AC is the side. Understood? What is the included side between two angles?
Yes, ma'am.
It is not which angle is which angles are given. Okay. Again, another triangle. It was what was the triangle given to you? PQR, I think. It was DEF, isn't it? DEF.
Okay, angle A and angle B, included side is angle AB.
Yes, side AB. Not angle AB, side A.
Side
AB. Okay. Now, DEF. Suppose DEF is given. Can you tell me what is the included side between D and angle E?
DE.
DE. What is the side between angle DE and angle F?
EF.
EF.
Yeah, EF. Then angle D and angle F between DF.
EF.
Side of. Okay, that's all. Now, let us see the first question. Look at this. Two triangles are given to you in the first question. Can you see the board properly?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So look at the first question given. So we are going to find out ASA congruence criterion. ASA congruence. ASA congruence says that this figure I will draw. I'll draw this figure, then it will be clear to you. This one, right, draw this triangle ABC, and DEF. Two triangles are given to you, 60, 40, here it is 60 degree, here it is 40 degree, and 3.5 centimeters. Then here A, B, 3.5 centimeters. Then 40, 60. 40 degree, 60. Okay. Now, what is ASA congruent saying is, if you enter middle of the theory, no, nothing you can understand. Huh? Sneha is entering now. Now, 3.5 centimeters, 3.5 centimeters. These are the two triangles given to you. And you are asked to find out the congruence and write it. Okay, we have to write it in the symbolic form. So, how will you write it?
Ma'am, what is the measurement of A, C, E?
3.5. Look at the board.
Ma'am, angle.
From the figure, what you can write? From the figure, what you can write? There is an angle A, which is equal to 40 degrees.
Okay. Angle F.
Angle A is 40 degrees. That is equal to angle F. Okay. So, angle A is equal to angle F. I can write, isn't it? Angle A is equal to angle F. Then, what I can write? Angle B will be equal to?
Angle E.
B is equal to angle E. Isn't it? Angle A of first triangle is equal to angle F of second triangle. Angle B of first triangle is equal to angle E of second triangle. Okay. Now, entering in between. Now, you see, what is the side AB is congruent to side EF of the second triangle. AB, side AB, line segment AB is equal to line segment EF of the second triangle. Isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
In the figure. So, what congruence, according to ASA congruence, if two angles and one side of one triangle is equal to two angles and one side, that is the included side of the other triangle, then the triangles are congruent. So can we use ASA congruence and establish a congruency between these two triangles?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, because we have angle A is equal to angle F, angle B is angle A is of this triangle, that is equal to angle F of other triangle. Then again, angle B of this triangle is equal to angle E of the other triangle. Then again, AB, the side AB of first triangle is equal to side EF of the second triangle. Isn't it? So, what is ASA congruence says is that if two angles and the included side of one triangle is equal to the two angles and included side of the other triangle, then the triangles are congruent. That is ASA congruence condition. Okay, so we can, what is the congruency? How will you write it symbolic form? In the symbolic form, how will you write it? Which are the two triangles congruent now? We have written for SAS, SSS and all.
Triangle ACB and triangle DES.
Triangle. So we will start with the sides which are equal. No? That will be more easy. AB should be equal to EF. So let us start with AB. What is the next sign? C. Okay. Triangle may or may not be same. Okay. We can start like that and check. So we started with ABC. And what about EFB? I simply started. We can check EFB. Okay. Let us check whether they are equal. AB should be equal to what? EF. That condition is okay. Then angle A should be equal to angle F. It is wrong. See, it is wrong. So we cannot take that. Then what else we can take? We'll take ABC. Okay. No problem. One triangle we can take ABC. So how we will write it? You should write the congruency. AB should be equal to EF. Okay. AB should be equal to EF. So, if I'm taking ABC here, find out.
FED.
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 BED. No, no, BED. ABC is the triangle. ABC is the one triangle, no? So, AB, then? Angle should be same.
Ma'am, EFB.
Ma'am, FED.
Triangle.
Ma'am, angle FED.
FED, right? FED you can write. Okay, just let us check. AB should be equal to EF. Okay, that is correct. That is correct. Now, second one is angle B should be equal to angle E. That is also correct. Now, what? Last one, angle A should be equal to angle F. That is also correct. So, we can say that triangle ABC is congruent to...
But the only non-angles need to verify, right?
Only not these things, only we have to see whether it is matching or not. Okay. Then only we can say by ASA congruence, it is congruent. Okay. By ASA congruence, write it properly, congruence, ASA congruence. ASA congruence. Can you see the board?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Is it clear? Board is visible to you?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. So did you understand what is ASA congruence condition, children?
Yes.
No. Two angles and one side, that is included side of one triangle, should be equal to two angles and the included side of the other triangle. Then we can say that the triangles are congruent.
Two angle and one side.
Two then, angles and one side. Two angles and included side. Not any side. Two angles and the included side of this triangle should be equal to two angles and the included side of the other triangle. Okay. Then we can say that the triangles are congruent. Like this, we have to write the equal parts. And then we'll do some problems. Then it will be clear to you. One more problem we can do. I don't know why other classes, they did it very well. Huh? No doubt was there like this. Which one? Another problem I'll give you. Okay, we can just write down this question. Just draw this figure, okay? It's 3:30 now. Just draw this figure. I think after doing that, it will be clear to you. Yeah, this figure. Draw this figure first, roughly. Don't need to take scale and all. With pen, draw it fast. Okay, then I'll show you the question.
Angle C is equal to angle D of another triangle.
You just check, see the question given. Question is there. Just write down this question. Question is asking whether we can say triangle AOC is congruent to triangle BOD. That is asked. Boys, please answer. Okay. Where is Mohammed Hishan? Is he present today? Hishan, are you present today? No. No answer. Okay, AOC congruent to BOD. That is the question. Check whether triangle AOC is congruent to triangle BOD. Okay, let us see. I'll come back to the meeting. Okay, video is switched off. Okay, see children, our question is whether triangle AOC is congruent to triangle BOD. By looking at the figure, can you tell me anything?
Yes.
Angle C is congruent to angle D.
It's the same, right? In both. It's so particularly opposite angle, right?
Yes, angle. Who answered? Is it Alvin? Who is that? Ashwin, are you answering? Ashwin?
None that O, angle O is going to vertically opposite angle, right?
Okay, angle O we can say 30 degree, isn't it? Okay, can you see the board now? Board? Oh. Yes, you can see the board, no? The figure was this. The figure was this. Angle O here is equal to angle O here, isn't it?
Angle COA is congruent to angle DOB.
DOB, okay. Now, what can you tell? This is 30 degree. Then what about this is also 30 degree. This is 70 degree. You have to consider it as two triangles. Two triangles. This is one triangle. This is one triangle. And this one is another one. Blue color is another triangle. This is another triangle. Okay. This is another triangle. Now, tell me, two triangles I have drawn. Here we have 70 degree, 30. What about this angle?
80 degree,
because 70 plus 30 is 100. And this one, so 180 degree, no? One triangle means what is the total degree measure? 180 degree. So this is 70 plus 30, 100. Remaining is what? 80 degree. 180 total. So what about this one?
Angle AOC is congruent to angle BOD.
Okay. See, 70 degree here, 30 degree here. So remaining 70 plus 30, 100. Remaining is 80 degree. 80 degree. So we can say that now we need ASA congruence condition. Okay. So here this angle and this angle of this triangle is equal to, see, this angle A of this triangle is equal to angle B of this triangle, 80 degree both. Now, don't write, listen now. Now, and 70 degree angle C is equal to
angle
D. Angle D of other triangle. Okay, then what about the included side in between? This is 3 centimeter. We can take it as centimeter. 3 centimeter. Its included side is DB.
DB.
That is also 3 centimeters. So can we apply ASA congruence in these two triangles? This is first triangle, this is second triangle.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Ma'am. So you see this once more. This is 80 degree. This is 80 degree. So we can say angle A is equal to angle B of the other triangle. Then angle C is equal to angle D of other triangle, isn't it? 70 degree. Then we can say the included side AC is equal to the included side of BD of other triangle. Now three congruent conditions are satisfied, isn't it? Two angles and included side. So we can say by ASA congruence, these two triangles are congruent. Okay. These two triangles are congruent. Now our question is, which two triangles? How can you name the triangles in relation with this congruence?
ACO.
I know. Our question is not to find that. They are asking only this, whether this congruence is correct or not. So our question is, you have to simply check it. Whether that condition is equal, correct or not. Triangle congruency is correct or not. Triangle AOC is congruent to triangle BOD. They are saying, is it correct or not? That is a question.
Yes, so ma'am, it's correct.
Correct.
We can check. CAC, angle A is equal to angle B. Okay, correct. See, angle A is equal to angle B. Angle A here, angle B here. Same place. First place, yeah. Correct. Then O is O. No need to check. It is not applied anywhere here. Now, angle C is equal to angle D. Yes, that condition is also satisfied. Isn't it? Now, what is the last one? AC is equal to BD. AC is equal to?
Ma'am, attendance. Yes,
ma'am. Attendance LD. So, all the three conditions are satisfied. So, we can say, yes, this is correct. Triangle AOC is congruent to triangle BOD by ASA congruence. Okay, ASA congruence. Did you understand now what is ASA congruence, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, that's all. That is what is known as ASA congruence. You can see the board?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
You have one more period today. Isn't it? Last period.
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
It is in board 4. Board 4.
Please send the link of board 4 on the WhatsApp.
Board 4. Okay. I'll send it.
Ma'am, you have sent it in last Tuesday.
Yeah, I have sent it. Last Tuesday I have sent. Anyway, I'll send it once more to you.
Ma'am, it is going this much late.
Afridi, did you understand this?
Yes, ma'am.
So I will be asking next period, I'll be asking what is SSS congruence, ASA congruence, SAS congruence.
ASA congruence, I don't understand it.
Which one? ASAS.
ASA congruent.
Simply here two angles are coming. Other one is simply two sides are coming. That's all. Okay, if you want, I'll be asking all the three to everybody. Okay, come prepared. Okay, children. So shall we leave now?
Yes, ma'am.
Wait. Attendance is there. Oh, 3:45. Next period, I'll take attendance. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Bye, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.